The other things which it can help is the other things which your common issues which can be addressed by prospective DVR is one among those things is your drug patient precaution. Means what is the drug patient precautions? Means whenever you are giving any drug to any patient, what are the precautions to be taken regarding the patients, right? Certainly when we see a normal disease conditions or a patient who is of young age and who don't have any multiple complications, we don't have any issues. But when we see aged people who is having certain complications and all, there comes the issue. Like it would be like we have to consider the age or gender or certain the parameters. So first thing among those one is the age, right? So here it says what age precautions to be taken. So whenever you see age precautions, generally whenever we already know that if a patient is age, means when its age is getting increased, what happens? Obviously his kidney functions will be reduced, means his excretion or removal of wastage thing will be decreased. Like we already know, almost the nephrons will lose its function when the people become age, right? So obviously when the age is increasing, nephrons is losing its function, what happened? There will be a sedimentation of other drugs which we are giving at the doses, right? So that's why whenever you see, they will be saying pediatric doses guidelines and geriatric doses guidelines. I mean, geriatric means aged people. As the drug cannot eliminate entirely from the body, so what we'll be doing, we'll do the dose calculations, we'll give the different dose to the adults and we'll give different dose to the old age people like geriatrics, right? Next one comes with allergy. So allergic thing, like this is a normal thing for everyone, ma. Generally we see general allergies, like some people will be having allergic to penicillin, some people will be having allergic to azithromycin, some people will be having allergy to some certain foods also. So we have to see the patient's allergic history, then we have to give. And if patient says you don't have any allergic history, what we can do is, if the drug what we are prescribing, consider if you have any of the allergic things, so what we can do, we can just give the test dose first, then we can give the remaining drug. And that's why whenever we see penicillins, if a patient is of complicated disease conditions, what generally doctors will do, they'll just give the test dose first, means they'll be giving a minute dose and see is there any allergic reactions or not. If the allergic reaction persists, they'll go for other antibiotics, right? If there is no allergic reaction, test dose, then they'll give the normal dose also, right? Next one is gender and pregnancy. Like you already know the pregnancy category drugs, there are so many drugs, like the example of methotrexate or certain antibiotics, avermectin or some other drugs. This drug should not be given at the time of pregnancy and breastfeeding, right? Like what happens whenever you give avermectin or some other drugs at the time of breastfeeding, there is a chance this drug will reach the breast milk, which will enter into the baby, which can cause certain reactions, right? So that's why really whenever you are dealing with pregnant women and lactating mothers, you have to be so careful, ma, right? That's about your drug patient precautions. Next one is formulary substitutions. So formulary substitutions, here what do you mean by this one is, supposing a doctor has prescribed the medicine and that medicine is not available in the hospital, then you can interchange with the other medicine of same class, or that is therapeutic interchange. And next one is generic substitution. Means suppose doctor prescribed Dolo, but in your hospital Dolo is not there, you can Calpol or Crocin, some other thing of same dose. That is generic substitution. You don't have much problem with this, but we should get prior approval from the doctor before we change anything from his prescription. So therapeutic interchange, when it happens, means consider it can be the non-availability of the drug, or it can be the patient was allergic to it, or it can be some other reasons where you want to change the drug. Supposing you want penicillin or not, ampicillin is not available, you have to go for amoxicillin, or you want to go for some other drug, or omeprazole has been prescribed, you don't have omeprazole, you want to give pantoprazole. That whenever you are changing this one thing to other thing, you will do the drug therapy review, sorry, your drug utilization review, which says why the drug has been prescribed, whether the medicine is not available in the hospital or doctor has prescribed certain wrong thing. So here we'll be checking it out. What is the problem with the pharmacy or the problem with the prescriber? We'll get the details here. Next one is inappropriate duration of therapy. So inappropriate duration of therapy is the best example, like your antibiotics. So if the doctor gives for 7 days, most of the people nowadays, what happen, whenever they feel the symptoms has been reduced, they will stop taking the drug instead of 7 days. Consider patient went to doctor with respiratory urinary tract infection, burning micturations and all the increased urinary frequency, urinary urgency and all. But what happens, whenever doctor is given for 7 days, doctor has given the medicine for 7 days, but patient symptoms has been reduced within 5 days of the treatment. So what happens, obviously the patient stop taking in 5 days, so which leads to wrong therapy, which leads to inappropriate duration. And next one here, what happens, consider that has gone for 7 days, we have used it for 7 days, we have used it for 7 days and still the symptoms are not reduced. So what you have to do, you have to go to the doctor and you have to go to the doctor and ask, doctor, you have given this medicine but there was no efficacy. Then he will change the prescription. But what people will do, I will go to doctor instead of again have to pay money there, I had to go and come back, I'll use same medicine for another 3-4 days and see, if not I'll go to the next doctor, another doctor. This is also inappropriate duration of the drug treatment. And another example, like when you see discharge summaries, like I said, almost 30% of discharge summaries which are, I have seen in my experience, are losing any one or other components, like dose won't be there, route won't be there, or duration won't be there. They'll write everything. They'll write how many times, in how many days, how many times in a day, how to take and when to take. But they don't write the duration, like 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, 8 days, 10 days. They don't write that one. So what happens, obviously, it leads to inappropriate duration of the therapy. These are all examples of these are the issues which a prospect reviewer can address. Yes, ma'am. And then the next thing is examples for this thing. I think we already seen this one. So patient being treated with warfarin has been given a medicine, NSAID for arthritis by another physician, other specialist, which can increase internal bleeding. So upon reviewing this patient's prescription, the pharmacist noted that there is a potential drug interactions. Okay, it's another example, like we already seen this one. Next one, going for this concurrent drug utilization review. So concurrent drug utilization review is nothing but here the patient is taking the medicine, okay, and whenever he is taking the medicine for a duration of 5 days or 10 days or 7 days or 15 days, you are following the patient clinical review. You are seeing how the patient treatment is happening, like is there any new areas are happening, any side effects are happening, or some other things is there, or where we need to improve the therapy. All those things should be checked in this concurrent review. Concurrent means at the time, present. Yeah. So concurrent review is performed during the course of the treatment. During the course of the treatment, which involves the ongoing monitoring of the drug therapy for faster positive patient outcomes. For faster positive patient outcomes means, like you already know, whenever we see, whenever we follow up the patient clinical conditions day by day, we will be having certain, we can do certain changes where we can improve the patient condition, we can stabilize the patient immediately, right? Immediately in a sense, soonly, right? So what are the advantage of this type of review is, this type of review will allow the patient to alter any if necessary. It's not like just you give the treatment for 7 days, you just leave the patient like that aside. Whenever you go for checking the patient or for bedside counseling or for what rounds, when you go for follow-up, definitely one or other thing can be seen, like it can be an ADR of the drugs, or it can be nasocomial infection, right? It can be anything. Like some most of the conditions, what happens if the sanitary conditions are not good in surgery departments or any of the hospital departments, there will be occurrence of new infection happen to the patient which he don't have because of improper sanitation works and storage conditions. Next, this concurrent drug utilization review will help the pharmacist to alert to any potential problems and intervene in areas such as, right, what are the areas a pharmacist can intervene with this concurrent type of VREs? Any drug-drug interactions, duplication of the therapy, over or under utilization, excessive or insufficient dosing. So first one, drug-drug interactions, like your ciprofloxacin and iron, some other thing. Next, duplication of the therapy, like I said, paracetamol given twice because of like different generic names or different brand names, sorry, not different generic, different drug names, different brand names, so by confusion he has given, or by lookalike sound alike he has given, those kind of things. Next, over or underutilization. So overutilization, underutilization, like which kind of leads to what you call as to cross-check your drug abuse or drug misuse, or not giving these narcotics and psychotics which we have seen, those which are full prescription days, like we can give for half, then we can ask them to come back and take it again. Next, excessive or insufficient dosing, like whenever you see the aspirin of dose of aspirin for antiplatelet effect is some other thing, and dose of aspirin for analgesic or antipyretic effect is some other thing. So that has to be taken care, right? So again, that's the same thing, insufficient dosing and excessive dosing, like in case of children, whenever you see the dose of paracetamol for children is different and adult is different. So you just have to take care of the dosing. So that thing can be taken care in case of concurrent drug utilization review. And generally, nowadays when you see in a big hospitals or in a big clinics, what's happening? Everyone is following electronic prescribing. Means they will just type in a system and the pharmacist will take a printout and you will give medicine to the patient, right? So that's what, whenever you we are following this electronic prescribing, there is a less chance of ADRs. Like whenever it's electronic prescribing, we've already seen in previous class, there is a multiple and cross checks will be there, where if you prescribe something wrong, something irrationally, it will be showing certain operational interventions. Like this drug cannot be given, this drug cannot be given, certain pop-ups or certain alerts will be shown in a software or when you're prescribing in the systems, right? Here, as being a part of this electronic prescribing, has become a practice of it. A prescriber, what he will do, he will allow the pharmacist to do certain interventions. Like what he will do, the prescriber at the time of prescription transmission to the pharmacy, means here the physician will send a prescription to the pharmacy so that he can cross-check, is there any drug dosing or some other thing. See, the physician will do it. The physician will do the concurrent DVR thing, but he will once again follow up, send the thing to the pharmacy so that he can cross-check and give if he can do any changes, is there any things need to be changed. But the important thing here is, if you want to do a drug utilization review, we cannot do with only the prescription which I written at that time. We need the prescriptions of the patient from the starting of the time when he has admitted in the hospital, or how many times he might have visited the hospital. All those prescriptions we should need. Because when we are saying, supposing patient came to you with respiratory tract infection this year, sir, last year, you given medicine, it was reduced. And again next year he came, you are given that it is reduced. But next year when he came, even if he give, what happens? If there was any irrational use, it won't cure. We cannot cure that one. At that time, we have to go for a high dose of antibiotics, or we have to change from narrow to broad, or broad to narrow spectrum antibiotics, right? So whenever you have the concurrent medication and the previous histories, then we can go for a better treatment. And we can see for any therapeutic interchanges or any those kind of things also can be seen here. And even, yeah, the same work like your concurrent DVR will be obviously performed by the pharmacist, okay? Next, issues commonly addressed by your concurrent DUR, drug disease interactions. It's just like I think what you have seen, example is same for what we have seen in your prospective DUR. Like okay, drug disease interaction, we can see renal problem with ciprofloxacin, you should not give. Next, drug-drug interactions, ciprofloxacin and iron. Next, drug dose modifications based upon the age, body weight and all. Okay, next thing is drug patient precautions, like based upon age and disease conditions or pregnancy category, category X drugs and all. That next, overuse and replication and therapeutic interchange. So here what's happening, we cannot say only these issues will be addressed by prospective, only this issue will be addressed by concurrent. So what happens, these are the common issues which can be happen at any stage, like at time of prescribing and before dispensing and at time of taking medicines or at the time of completing the medication treatment. Anytime it can happen, anytime it can be reduced. Okay, and one of the examples, yeah, this is same what we have seen. So generally this concurrent drug utilization reviews will be happened at institutional settings, because when we say institutional setups, means we have inpatients. If it is outpatients, we don't have much data to deal with, whereas if it is inpatient, the patient will be available there at any time and we can go and we can collect the data, we can see the multiple medication what they are using, right? Next one, periodic review of your patient records will be helpful in finding out actual and potential drug-drug interactions and duplicate therapy. Duplicate therapy or duplication of the drug means they're prescribing twice and thrice or any drug-drug interactions. Because what happened, if patient or doctor is writing a prescription for the day one, he is writing all the drugs for the first time, so not an issue. But day two, whenever he is writing, if there is day three, whenever he is writing, if there is any new indication or new symptom of the patient where we have to give new drug, at that time what happens, if in emergency prescriber didn't check what medication he has given at the day one or day two to the patient, and if he write any medication which will interact with the drug which you have prescribed already on day one, that will be an issue. To avoid that one, a clinical pharmacist will check for this concurrent drug utilization review. Next one, need for changes in the medication. Yeah, obviously if there is any need for changes in therapy based upon your lab test results, like consider a patient came to you with a certain disease condition, okay, and you went medicine to the patient, and in between what happened, his liver function or his kidney function got reduced. So at that time what we have to do, we have to go for change in the dose or we have to change the drug also, it can be anything. Okay, so that thing should be checked, right? So that's how your concurrent drug utilization review will help. Next one is your retrospective DUR. So what is this retrospective DUR, how it can help, right? So this retrospective DUR will be happen after completing the dispensing, after medicine is dispensed and the patient has taken the medicine. So now you can get it out. See, once the medication is dispensed and patient already taken the medicine, what is needed of doing any of this studies and all, because the patient has already taken the medicine. So what is the need of, what is the benefit of doing here? But the benefit of doing this one here is to change the prescription pattern, to change the upcoming prescription pattern by the specific doctor and all. We can just check in here about this. Okay, and the next thing what we are going to see here is, like we already seen, retrospective DUR occurs after drug therapy, after the patient has received the medication. Means the patient has taken the medication, after that we will see the prescription, means how the prescription has been given, is according to the predetermined criteria or not, is there any deviation from the guidelines, like he started in first line of drug to any disease condition, he has gone second line of drug, or any those kind of things. Okay, so in here the major aim of this retrospective DUR is to detect the patterns in prescribing, dispensing, and administering the drugs. So administering the drugs in a sense, like taking the drugs, like before food, after food, or will we say along with IV, like how much time they are taking to give this drug and IV in patients, all these things will be checked. Next, okay. So based upon the current pattern of medication use, the prospective standards and target interventions can be developed. Means once we know what is the standard of medication prescribing and usage in any particular site or particular hospital, then based upon that, we can see the standards and we can improve the standards at any time, like, because improving standards is one of the continuous improvement process. We can see that, okay? And apart from improving it, and if there is any problem, we can prevent the reoccurrence of inappropriate medication use also. We can prevent the prescription pattern of inappropriate medication also. Right, next one. Outcomes of these two may be aid prescribers in improving care of the patient, okay? So like generally when you see a specific group of populations like hypertension, diabetes, asthma, epilepsy, some other thing. So what happens, even being individual or we see certain cases, or we in a group, if we see collect certain cases, what happens, there will be a specific prescription pattern which cannot be given 100% treatment to any one or two people in a group because of comorbidities, because of some other conditions which has to be taken care. Okay. Okay, what are the common factors, common issues which can be addressed by your retrospective year is as same as the other things, because I already said everything are same almost. Appropriate generic use when there is any substitution and all. Next, clinical misuse or abuse, so which can be reduced by giving limited number of drugs or patient counseling. Next, drug dose contraindications, kidney problems, ciprofloxacin, drug-drug interactions, obviously ciprofloxacin and iodine. Next, inappropriate duration of therapy, using drugs for more than the given or less than the given duration. Incorrect drug doses, aspirin with different uses, different doses are there. Next, use of formulary medication whenever appropriate, that should be taken care. Next, overuse or underutilization of the drugs. It can be the dose, it can be the route, anything. Therapeutic appropriateness and or duplication also should be cross-checked and verified, right? Yes, ma'am. This is about your entire drug utilization review process. Okay, so now let us see again the one or two difference between drug utilization review and drug utilization evaluation. Okay, so let us see the example of this first. So analysis of members' prescription utilization may identify for a group of patients whose therapy does not meet the approved guidelines. So here they are going to see where the guidelines are not approved for any specific group of people, right? So because the deviation may be any of the reason, it can be true reason for deviation, it can be false reason for deviation, right? Upon doing your retrospective drug utilization review, the pharmacist may identify a group of people with asthma who are not getting inhalation corticosteroids as the initial stage, where they are getting some other class of drugs than your inhalation corticosteroids. So that things can be taken care, which can be avoided for the next patients. Yeah, so now we will discuss the difference between drug utilization evaluation and drug utilization review.